That's what I said. I'm not hating on Sophie Rain. Get that bag, bro. Anyway, you get that bag, my go get that bag, bro. But I'm saying, like, y'all made this girl rich and she really like mid-mil. I could probably go to the mall and see like 10 Sophie Rains, bro.
Promise that I was never finna talk about this girl again, and I truly did want to hold true to that promise, bro. But I'm sorry, there's just no way I could see this headline and not talk about it. So at the time of me,
I saw this too. I was like, bruh,
a time where you spend
58 mil in a month,
you give thanks to the things that you've gotten and received that year. During Thanksgiving, Sophie Rain decided to tell the internet what she was thankful for, and what she was thankful for shocked everyone. Sophie Rain tweeted out that she made over $43 million from 1 year of doing OnlyFans.
$43 million in a year is nuts, bro. Y'all niggas. Oh my. I was talking to Kendrick about this shit earlier. When I saw this picture, I'm like, bro, the fact that y'all. It's not the. I can't even explain it, bro.
Bro, this porn is free. NBA contract money off of a porn website. What are we talking about? This
porn is free, bro.
Society come to. I like this tweet that this guy Maury made. People mad at Sophie Rain for making 40 mil on OnlyFans instead of being mad at the losers who paid all
exactly.
Her content. This is capitalism, supply and demand. And he's exactly right.
Exactly. I mean, at this point, I can't even be it's not her fault. It's y'all
for making this amount of money. I mean, like, bro, if women paid me to post some ass pictures or some shirtless pics, like, I would do. So y'all do know that she's not actually posting porn on there. All she's doing is posting Instagram bikini pics. Don't ask Kyle to know that. And she's making $43 million a year. That is absolute.
That's the craziest part. She's not even posting like sex, bro.
Crazy. There is no reason why she should be able to make that amount of money off of just posting pictures. And to every single guy who has paid for her OnlyFans, you should be ashamed of yourself.
Absolutely.
I really don't care if you was jerking off to that shit or you just wanted to message Sophie Rain, aka her manager. But this is truly just insane.
I don't get it, bro. I really don't. I don't understand it, bro. The shit is free. You can find this shit everywhere else for free, bro. It's free, bro. It's free.
Bro, and a lot of people are making soul ties to a girl by jerking off. Yes, you can do that. And paying her millions of dollars just so they can feel better about them.
That's the crazy. That's the craziest part. Like, bro, I get, like I always say, bro, I never, ever, ever hate on anyone for getting that bag. Shout props to Sophie Rain and Corinna for getting that bag from OF, bro. But I'm mad at the niggas who are paying for it, bro. I'm mad at the niggas who are paying for it because it's like, bro, you can't be that serious. You can't be that down bad, bro. You cannot be that down bad, bro. The shit is free. Shit is free. And so I guess the same could be said about streamers and YouTubers and stuff like that, but bro,
more than NBA players do. And I'm not just talking about role players. I'm talking about the big guys. He's making more than Jason Tatum.
See, this is the type of shit to make me want to quit everything and sell feet pictures. Sophie Rain
feet pictures is
made
nuts.
$43 million this year. She literally made more than this nigga Jason.
No, actually, if we sit down and really look at this, bro, she is making more money for posting bikini pictures, not even having sex on screen. She's just posting pictures. She is making more than a nigga who actually has to show out and perform and lift weights and be good at a sport, bro. Actually nuts.
Tatum.
Crazy.
I didn't even Google it, but I did.
And I'm not gonna lie, bro. Again, I'm not on my hater trend or anything like that, but like Sophie Rain is really like mid-milk, bro. We did this shit for mid-milk, my nigga. We did this shit for mid-milk, bro. Come on, man.
She might be making more than LeBron.
Okay, bro. Hold on, bro. More than LeBron is a little much, my nigga. I think LeBron makes like 50 mil.
King Pookie LeBron James. We gotta stop.
This nigga's a glazer.
But still,
oh, she's close.
Girl only making $5 million less than the greatest basketball player of all time.
That is kind of nuts.
Insane thing I've seen in a minute. And I'm not on here to hate on her like some niggas would, because I really feel like she deserves that bag. Like, what would?
That's what I said. I'm not hating on Sophie Rain. Get that bag, bro. Anyway, you get that bag, my nigga. Go get that bag, bro. But I'm saying, like, y'all made this girl rich and she really like mid-milk. She's like mid-milk. Maybe I can't just walk down the street, but like, I can probably go to the mall. I can probably go to like, I don't know, any like an arcade or some shit and see like 10 Sophie Rains. You know what I'm saying? I can probably go to the mall and see like 10 Sophie Rains, bro. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. She's really like, she kind of like basic mid milk, bro. I'm not gonna lie.
To see you. I mean, shit, for 43 M's now. I'd be doing the same thing.
That's what I said.
I'm not finna oil up the abs and the arms and you start striking pose for the money. But I'm for damn sure not finna oil up my booty cheeks and shit. I don't know about that.
That's OD.
You got that.
Why are niggas
S-O-D.
So down bad? I know it's a lot of crusty, dusty niggas doing that shit too. This really might show that our society is definitely cooked.
But the thing that gets
absolutely cooked
is I feel like a lot of people are lying about them buying OnlyFans. Because those two demographics are a big demographic, but there's no way that equates to 43 million a year. Then also, let's talk about this again. She's making more money than one of the best basketball players in the whole entire world does.
Now, look, I know niggas hate Jason Tatum. I'm not gonna lie, I'm probably one of them niggas too. He just irks my nerve, my nigga. But he is a good player, bro.
Is that not crazy to y'all, bro? Crazier part is she's not the only one. Karina Koff, another OnlyFans girl, also leaked how much money she was making a while back. And she's making very similar numbers to Sophie Rain.
Oh, that is disgusting. I need to cut myself.
Is that number right there?
Jesus, this one right here.
I mean, that's what I made. That's what I took home.
In 3 years.
This is like what I...
And she doesn't even like...
That's my look at my first month.
3 years.
Oh my god.
That's public.
$67 million, Colonel.
You're $67 million.
This is crazy, bro. These niggas are not. This is she's making more than the greatest basketball player of all time in 1 year, bro. $67 million.
Dollars in 3 years.
Oh, it was 3 years. Never mind.
There's plenty of websites where y'all can get this shit for free. And I feel like this is a worn down argument that every YouTuber
Cornhub
has made at least 5 times. But seeing these numbers really just pisses me off because I'm doing this YouTube shit, right? I'm working hard every single day, struggling just to get a fraction of what they're making. Yet they're taking bikini pics and they're making more money than my whole bloodline has made combined. Like, what are we talking about? And what's even crazier is that Karina has actually retired from doing OF content like she's some type of basketball player.
Karina Koff she did has say officially that. Announced her retirement from OnlyFriends. When I say OnlyFriends, you all likely know what I'm talking about. I can't say the...
I mean, like, come on, niggas! This is never any hate towards the women, bro. Like, does Sophie Rain look good? Sure. Does Karina look good? Sure. But, nigga, like I said with Sophie Rain, I could go to the mall and see plenty of Sophie Rains. I can go to the mall and see a few Karinas, bro. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. That shit is like, these are not like one of a kind. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. I'm not hating, but at the same time, I'm gonna keep it real with y'all niggas. This is not a one of a kind woman, bro. I'm just being real,
actual
bro.
Name, but on the site, you know, she would post pictures.
Only friends.
And videos
we're
of
only
herself,
friends, chat.
A lot of people would spend.
You could probably. Devil's advocate, bro. You could probably go on Cornhub and find a Sophie Rain lookalike. You could probably go on Cornhub and find a Karina lookalike, bro. I'm just keeping it a stack with you, bro.
Sure. See them. And she announced this earlier today. She removed all the links from her bios. And I believe if you go on the website and look up her name, her account will no longer be there.
Imagine
you know
making $67 million and then deleting the account.
Good for her. I'm sure a lot of people out there are actually going to be pretty upset to hear about this news because, you know, she had a lot of fans on this site. And
I'm not going to lie. If you're upset from hearing that Karina Koff has retired, bro, you got to retire your meat, man. You got to put
yeah,
that
Yeah, bro,
meat,
you got to relax, bro.
That
shit is nuts.
That she is likely a first ballot OnlyFriends Hall of Famer. That is for sure.
First ballot OF Star Hall of Famer is crazy. Usually I would try to hate on these girls, but I can't even honestly get mad at them for making this type of money when y'all are paying these girls. As men, we got to lock in and stop giving these girls this type of money. I'm sure there's a lot more OF girls that make millions of dollars. They just don't say anything. Yet y'all
absolutely
still keep on buying their content.
This give is nuts.
Buying their package deals, texting these girls thinking that you're talking to them when it's just their manager. Another popular OnlyFriends creator that makes a lot of money is also technically a streamer named Amaranth.
Amaranth made $2 million in just 1 month.
Whoa. I don't know her as a gooner, nigga. I know her as a Twitch streamer, bro. let's clarify that.
In a recent interview with Jake Lucky, Amaranth revealed that the largest amount of money she's made from OF in 1 month was $2 million. She said it all comes from honest hard work.
Okay, y'all, let's not do that.
And it definitely makes it...
Let's not say honest hard work. Let's not do that, y'all.
Honest hard work? What are we talking about, honest hard work? Please?
Let's not do that, bro. Let's not do that.
It's hard for the who's jerking.
What's the biggest amount you've ever seen on a check?
I think it was like around $2 million that I withdrew.
Y'all think that's bad? I found this graphic on Twitter. Apparently, she makes 100K from Twitch. She makes 85,000 per year from gas stations. I guess that's an investment. She makes $1.5 million per month from OnlyFans.
She invested in gas stations? What?
I seen this other post on Twitter. This is absurd. I really can't comprehend how all of these girls are making this amount of money when apparently nobody buys OnlyFans. I'm sorry, but a lot of men nowadays are just lying gooners. If you finna be a gooner, at least go into free shit. I can't believe these girls.
That's what I'm saying, nigga. If you're embarrassed to be paying for OnlyFans, maybe you shouldn't be paying for OnlyFans, nigga. Nigga, the hub is free, bro. The hub is free, bro.
Money, bro. I'm literally jealous. And yeah, I said I'm jealous. I'm not finna sit here and act like I'm not. Like, every single content creator that makes a video about this is jealous. They're just not saying it. And I try to make my videos different. I don't want to talk about the same topics that everybody else talks about. But I just want to add a different perspective. Most of the time when we look at situations like this, we only look at the money or the people who are doing the gooning. We don't really look at the long-term effects of this. We already have a crazy Twitter, gooning yep. culture that's being built on the internet. Like, it's becoming normalized to be addicted to gooning. If one of your boys told you that he goons every single day, you're looking at him like he's a fucking monster. Nowadays, it's just normal. Like, I be seeing people in TikTok comment sections talking about, yo, I haven't gooned in like 2 hours. I'm doing so good. Like, 2 hours? What are we talking about?
2 hours not gooning is nuts. That being an achievement is nuts. You're addicted, my nigga. You're addicted, bro.
And the thing that really concerns me is that it's mostly...
There are niggas who watch corn and aren't addicted. And then there's niggas who do that. And like, damn, it's really been 2 hours since I gooned. I'm making progress.
Little kids doing this. Like I said before, I guarantee a huge percentage of Sophie Rain subscribers are probably younger than the age of 15.
And while which is sad, bro. Can we think about that for a second, my nigga? A lot of her OnlyFans subscribers might actually be like 14-year-old boys, bro. That shit is nuts.
Huge problem with these OF girls marketing to kids. The Spider-Man costumes, the gamer girl, the innocent, oh, I'm Sophie Rain and I'm a virgin. Like, you're trying to market to kids, bro. It's obvious. That's these bad. OF girls are turning this next generation into gooners. And while I know they don't care because they're getting their bag, it is concerning. I know I said earlier I'm not finna hate on them for getting their bag because we all know they're just doing it for money. I think I'm finna actually retract my statement. I am finna hate on these girls because they're intentionally trying to market their OFs to...
Okay, yes. If I'm gonna agree with him here. If it's like you're intentionally trying to market to kids, then yes, I'm gonna hate on you. But if you're like, hey man, I'm just doing this shit for the money, then I can't hate on you for getting the bag, bro.
These kids is who I really feel bad for, because this next generation is gonna be so sexually mind corrupted. And if you don't believe that, I was sexually active when I was young and it corrupted my brain crazily. How can you look at,
bro, the effects of corn on the mind is actually nuts. I don't know if anybody has actually looked into that shit, but it's actually nuts how corn affects the mind, bro. That's why, like, once you get free of that shit, you start thinking clearly, you start realizing more things, you become a little bit happier. It's like...
yourself in the mirror. Let me know what y'all think, and hopefully somebody puts a stop to this shit, bro. It's getting nasty out here, I'm not gonna lie. Go follow my Twitch if you wanna hear me talk about topics like this more often, and it also gives you a platform where you can actually chat to me, and I can respond to your questions or takes of what I'm saying. I stream Monday, Wednesday, and Friday every single week, so go tap...
Damn, bro. Shout out, Cloud. I'm actually
probably streaming right now. If I was this nigga, I would throw this drink at him, bro.
Yeah. Nah, that's actually kind of fucking nuts, bro. That's actually nuts. I fuck with this video, though, Cloud. W Cloud. This nigga shit got banned. Damn, bro. I hope he gets that shit fixed soon.